to another episode of the Monkey Boy Presents, and today I'm happy to bring you a special presentation, my very first unboxing ever, featuring the Marvel Cinematic Universe Phase 1 Avengers Assemble Limited Edition 10-disc 6-movie collector's set. Whew, yeah, that's a mouthful, but it's awesome. I'm very thrilled to bring this to you. This arrived mere moments ago on my doorstep. And before I get too deep into this, too involved, I want to give a big shout out and thanks to my mom and my brother, who thought this would be a good idea to give me as a birthday gift. I recently celebrated a birthday, and this was one of the gifts I received. A little bit belated, but I'm very happy to have it. I thought that I would bring the excitement to you guys and do my very first unboxing, because I think this is going to be a great set. I'm really looking forward to opening it up. As you can see, the box itself is really nice. It's a glossy cardboard along with the blister case, so you can see through and you can see that metallic case, suitcase, briefcase that Nick Fury, played by Sam Jackson, of course, had in the Avengers movie, which contains the Tesseract, which was featured in Captain America and the Avengers. And of course, the Tesseract is a part of the set. It's really cool. It actually lights up. Although I have heard it's not as detailed as you might want, but it's still pretty cool that they decided to include it. I don't know if it's really showing up, but there's nice details on the case that show through here. This white part on the center here that almost looks like it's glowing or glowable is the S.H.I.E.L.D. logo, which you'll see in better detail once I open it up. It also shows that it features an exclusive look at Iron Man 3 and Phase 2 of the Marvel Universe, as well as it lists on the very bottom here every movie, starting with the very first Iron Man all the way through the Avengers, that is included with this set that is considered part of Phase 1. The side also just goes to reiterate that. It shows them with their logos, starting with the very first Iron Man on Blu-ray, working all the way to the Avengers, which Thor, Captain America, and the Avengers are available in 3D in this collection too, if you like that, which I don't, but take your pick. The back of the box is also very nice. It features what the case looks like once it's opened up. It has really nice details. You'll see more of that. It has all the circuitry and really cool little features and details that were in the film, including the Tesseract, which does light up, which I think is a great touch. It also includes S.H.I.E.L.D. operative status, which basically just means you get all these little files and things that detail every member of the Avengers, and within those files, it gives you security clearance to look at different things from the movies. Prop replicas, basically. Like Captain America's file contains a couple of the playing cards that Agent Coulson had collected that was featured in the Avengers. And Tony Stark's file as Iron Man features the blueprints for some of the various Iron Man armors that he has built, including the very first armor that he made inside of that cave in Iraq. It also features the different covers of the movies right here, which are really neat Art Deco minimalistic style. You can see there's just very few colors and all the heroes are silhouetted, which I just think is a really great touch, and I'll show you those in more detail once I have it open. And again, on the bottom here, it lists all the different movies and gives the synopsis for every film and their rating according to the MPAA. Which is also the same as what was on the DVDs or Blu-rays that you may have already purchased if you have bought every movie individually. Finally, the very top of the packaging, which I'm not going to try and go too crazy to show you, has a little cutaway, so you can push this button on top, which makes the S.H.I.E.L.D. symbol in the center glow, which is supposedly, of course, the energy of the Tesseract, which is just, I think, another really great touch. Thrilled to bring this to you. Hope you're staying tuned. Give me just a second here. We'll open it up, and then we'll take a look inside the Phase 1 Avengers Assembled Collector's Edition. And here it is, out of the box, the Marvel Phase 1 Collector's Edition in, of course, the S.H.I.E.L.D. case, which Nick Fury carried in the Avengers, which contains the Tesseract. And it's a perfect representation. Of course, it's not the same size. It's much, much smaller. And it's not made of metal. It's just a simple metallic silver paint to give the impression that it's made out of that metal. But it is very nice. It's very hard plastic, really strong, really durable. Shook my camera there a little bit. And it also has some really great details on the outside of the case. You can see the different grooves, how, you know, it has some definition to it, some three-dimensionality to it. You can also make out the S.H.I.E.L.D. logo on the center there is really well done. It looks perfect. The sides show some, you know, mock riveting. And again, the back also has some really nice detailing showing off the plating and that sort of thing. The top also is very nicely done. It has, of course, the clips where it, you know, hinges together, and the handle, which does fold down into the body of it with the Avengers logo right there, which is that switch to light up the logo on the front of the case. When you want to do that, that's exactly how you do it. You simply push the button and boom, the shield logo lights up. And then we open it up and we get to the really good stuff. This thing is awesome. I'm so excited to show it to you. When you open it up first, ooh, it glows all by itself. And you can see the Tesseract right there in the center. And it also has the Avengers logo illuminated, as well as the case itself. The inside of the case there glows too. It's a really awesome effect. And you can see it's just, it's pulled off really well. I love the Avengers logo, and this also, this plastic piece holds in all the different files and folders that detail the different members of the Avengers, the different characters from the movies. The movies right here are right here in these two slots on the case. And if I hold the case up like this, you can see just how nicely detailed, there we go, the bottom of the case is. You can see all the circuitry is redone to sort of look like it did in the movie. It's not quite as detailed, of course. The Tesseract has a nice blue glow to it, and you have this keypad over here in the corner, you know, so you need to input some number or key code in order to unlock the Tesseract itself. Really awesome details. Absolutely love the thing when you open it up. And then, of course, all the stuff up here is removable, starting with this confidential envelope with the shield logo. We'll get to that in a minute, as well as all the different files themselves that feature, of course, the different characters from the films. It also includes this little instruction sheet on how to take care of the Tesseract and the case, how to replace the batteries, so on and so forth in multiple languages. And finally, the certificate of authenticity showing that this is indeed approved by Marvel, is one of a kind, or is one of a few, so on and so forth, which I think is a really cool touch as well. We're going to take the case away here just momentarily so we can take a quick look at the different files. First file we'll look at here is the one that was right in front, detailed as the shield file with a level 7 security clearance or above required. I also like how each file folder has the little file name on the corner there, and they're not perfect. It looks as though, you know, a human being did it. It's great little touches like that, but of course the file folder itself is a nice black. You simply open it up. Ooh, you get all kinds of goodies inside each one of these. It's really fantastic. You have the modern age picture of the Tesseract as it appeared in the Avengers. There it goes. There's my camera focusing. Yay. In the case, I might add, that this is supposed to be in, which I think is a cool touch. And also, a nice glossy picture of the Tesseract as it appeared in Captain America, the first Avenger. You can see it's in this nice sepia tone, and it has the Hydra logo there in the corner. Really nice detail. Also, it includes a, I suppose, detailed report, for lack of a better term, all about the Tesseract and the energy it gives off and all the different information. You can see it's got all kinds of details. Come on, focus, focus. There it goes. just great, neat little things like this. It also has a quick bio, a SHIELD personnel file on Natasha Romanoff, also known as the Black Widow, played by Scarlett Johansson. You can see it has pictures from the movie and information about her. Lots of things left out, of course, because it's even above your security clearance, apparently. Also, a quick file on Clint Barton, also known as Hawkeye, played by Jeremy Renner in the films. Featured in Thor and the Avengers, really cool. Finally, it has a quick thing about Item 47, which was one of the Chitauri weapons that was recovered from the New York incident, which is part of a special short film included in the bonus materials with this set. You can see it has information about it. It also mentions that it's the only weapon that was recovered that still functions after that fight. Finally, in this folder is Agent Coulson's card from S.H.I.E.L.D., which is just fantastic. And there's a little bit of detail on the front and the back. Little Marvel logo in the corner there. So that's our first little file folder there, featuring information mostly about S.H.I.E.L.D. Moving on to the next one. And this one is all about Captain America. So, of course, I think it's really cool. The folder looks very, very old and aged and stained, as though it came from the 1940s. You can see it has him listed as inactive, and has all the different people that were his superiors listed. It's just cool. You can see the whole folder all the way around has neat texturing and staining and all sorts of things to it. It makes it look really, really cool. Open it up, and we have, again, like the shield one, all sorts of goodies. Woo, don't pull out. There we go. All kinds of cool, really, really cool stuff for this one. We, of course, have a picture of Steve Rogers before the super soldier treatment as that skinny little, almost anorexic looking dude, which is neat. And again, a really nice sepia tone. It sets the period nicely, front and back. Really nice. It has his top secret report on his application, about his application into the super soldier program, and details information about that. It also has his expulsion from one of his many times applying into the military. You can see he was given a rating of 4F, which is as low as you can possibly go. as well as a letter that was apparently sent to his home about fraudulent applications. If you remember in the movie, it's mentioned that he has applied numerous times to numerous recruitment stations and has been turned down over and over, and that that is illegal. And here you can see he was actually sent a notice about it, and it lists all the different places that he has applied and been rejected from. Also, his physical examination, which is why he failed with that 4F before he was taken into the Super Soldier program, which lists at the very bottom here all of his health issues, which I just think is hilarious and is perfect. There we go, it's focusing so you can see that if you want to. Finally, some of the greatest stuff, I think. It includes a picture, if I can pick it up here without bending it too much, of Peggy from the newspaper clipping that he took out of the movie. You can see it even has ragged edges as though he cut it, you know, in a hurry. And the coolest part is if you flip it over, it has want ads on the back from the same newspaper. So it looks legitimate. It looks really, really great. Also, it has the classic trading cards that, of course, Agent Coulson collected in the films. And it's just great. They're not bloodied, of course, which I appreciate. And they're really neat. Each one is unique. Each one is numbered. And one of the things I found the coolest, I used to collect trading cards. Anyone who out there who has, what's the first thing you do when you get a trading card? You flip it over to see what's on the back. And I got the biggest grin when I saw there is stuff on the back of these trading cards. Just little simple little things featuring some of the classic artwork of Captain America as he appeared in the 1940s comic books, I might add. And just fantastic, neat little excerpts, neat little quotes from the captain telling you to support your country, support the troops, that sort of thing. You can see the back of that other card, number 6 there. It focuses, there we go. And you can write on the back, if you want to, your own quote. And then we got one of him, which is off of one of the classic covers of him decking Adolf Hitler, which is really fantastic. And again, you flip it over, imitators beware, the captain is here, that kind of thing. It's just great. It's just, what a fantastic detail. And again, they look old, they look aged, they've got that yellow aging to them as though they were actually plucked out of the 1940s or someone has held on to them for that long. Last little bit we have is out of Steve Rogers' notebook, his sketchbook, which was featured in the movie, if you remember, especially, it was in a deleted scene for sure, of basically a monkey on a tightrope in the Captain America uniform, symbolizing, of course, how he felt in that role as nothing more than a propaganda tool at first. And I just think it's great. It looks as though it was sketched in pencil. I have friends that do this sort of artwork, and it looks legitimate. It's really fantastic. And again, the paper looks old, it looks aged, and it looks like it was ripped out of a notebook. Great, great touch. That's the Captain America folder. Gosh, I hope you guys are as entertained by this as I am, because I think this thing is just fantastic. Moving on, of course, to the next folder in the series. And this one probably has the most stuff out of any of them. It is the one that most are probably excited about, featuring, of course, Tony Stark. You can see his name is right there in the corner. And it was filed by Agent Romanoff about Tony Stark. I love how there's a coffee mug stain on the outside as though Nick Fury, you know, just wasn't caring about it, put his mug down on top of it and said, hey, I'll get to it later. Again, it's all across. You can see there's marks. It looks as though it has, you know, been handled. It's been around. Open it up. And of course, we have all kinds of goodies yet again. Lots of goodies for the Iron Man here. Featuring a newspaper clipping of who is the Iron Man, and I think it's cool. That was one of the very first leaked images of the suit on the set that was released to the media, which I think is kind of neat that they incorporated into this. And there's a whole article about it, set, of course, in the movie universe. And if you flip it over just to keep up with the realism, there's an advertisement for just some random place and some other random news articles. You know, just great touch. That realism is really fantastic with this whole set. The next really cool piece is the four pieces of parchment that are supposed to be the sketches that he did for the original suit in the cave in Iraq when he was being held prisoner. And if you look very closely, it's hard to see here, there are other markings and things on this paper. So this is kind of sort of hidden, although it is much more detailed here than it was in the movie. But if you take all four of these, which again look as though they've been ripped or have been made out of just random pieces that he's found, and you place them together perfectly, you can see it forms the armor. And when you put all four pieces together properly like that, you can replicate the Mark I armor that he built in the desert, which is just a really neat touch. The next really cool piece is this. It's a big blueprint, and I don't think I'm going to be able to show it all to you here because it is very large. But it's a blueprint of the arc reactor that Tony's father, Howard, and another really cool touch I thought on the blueprint, if you see, it has, of course, Howard Stark and Anton Vanko. So you Iron Man 2 fans, you know that, of course, was Mickey Rourke's daddy. And Mickey Rourke became the villain in that one, whose name escapes me. I apologize for that. Whiplash. There we go. Whiplash. It came to me. So there's the blueprint for the arc reactor, which I think is another great touch. And you could frame that if you wanted to. You could hang it on a wall as a poster. I, of course, am going to keep it in my folder here, but it is something that you could do with it. It also comes with a ticket to the Stark Expo from Iron Man 2, and it has all the information on there. Just fantastic. VIP, Friday the 10th, the cost up in the corner. If you flip it over, it even has the Expo logo. I mean, it's straight out of the film. It's really neat. And here's a neat piece. This is sort of a teaser for Iron Man 3, if I can pick it up without bending it. A business card for Aldrich Killian, who works for AIM, who is one of the new baddies, or supposed baddies at least, in Iron Man 3, which is a really cool bit to include here. Really like that. He's supposedly a part of this extremist armor and how they're working it into that film. Also, you have the Stark World Expo from 1964, the first one. You have one of the programs from that, and it has a list of all the different attractions, the time, hours of operation for the whole expo, and of course, a nice big fold-out map, which is very reminiscent of some of the theme parks like Walt Disney World or Universal Studios, and how those were laid out, or are still laid out anyway. Really, again, a fantastic little touch. Also, a napkin, the napkin that Tony wrote on in the first Iron Man after he was rescued for Pepper to make the press release that Stark Industries is no longer going to make weapons. And it is on an actual napkin. It is a tissue paper. It is folded properly. It has that same detailing across the edge as most napkins do. The mock coffee stain. Oh, it's just such a cool piece. And the last little bit in Iron Man's, I told you there was a lot in this one, again, if I can pick it up, is out of Howard Stark's journal. And it is a crude, rudimentary sketch of the Tesseract from Captain America, along with some of Howard's notes about how he theorizes it may possibly work. And again, you can see it looks as though it's been torn out of a journal. It looks as though it's handwritten. Just really, really nice touch. There's something else you can't really make out here, I don't think. You can sort of see some of the ink from the page before it has bled through, which I just think is a great touch. Of course, there is no previous page here, but it gives the implication that there was one, which is awesome. Really, really fantastic. Okay, Iron Man out of the way. Only two left to go, people. I know, I'm moving as fast as I can. On to the next one. And this next character, the next folder we're going to look at, details Thor, which is just simply listed as Puente Antigua, which of course was the city that he was found in. You can see this one was filed by Agent Coulson, and unlike Natasha's, it's nice and clean and pristine, as though he takes a little bit more pride in his job, which of course, if you know him from the movies, he does. It's clean again on the back as well. We open it up, and we find some really neat little things inside, including Thor's medical bracelet from his brief stint in the hospital from the movie. You can see they just listed him as Thor because they didn't have anything else to call him by, along with a couple of the sketches that he did in the journal of Jane Foster, kind of talking about how the different worlds work and the Tree of Life and, you know, the different realms and that sort of thing, which, again, I think is really cool. You can see it's on notebook paper. It's stained and looks used and, again, looks ripped out of a book, which is a great touch. It also comes with Jane Foster's ID card, which is neat, detailing what she does. If you find it, please return to the, please drop in a post office box, and it'll be sent back to her, along with Culver University's logo on the back. Really just great details. I mean, you could wear that to a Comic-Con or something if you wanted to, if you wanted to try and dress up as that character. There you go, there's your card. It also comes with a New York State driver's license for Dr. Donald Blake, with, of course, Thor's picture. And if you missed this in the movie, it was in the movie briefly. It's the fake ID they get for him. And it's a nod, of course, to the comic books. In the comics, for a while, Thor's human alter ego, when he was trapped in the body of a man, or they shared the same body, or even could switch back and forth, whatever, his name was Dr. Donald Blake. So that's just a neat little touch. The back even has the fake scanning barcode and all that stuff. Neat, neat piece. Of course, they're plastic too, which I failed to mention. It also has a printout of the picture that Darcy took of Thor inside of the anomaly that they capture in the very beginning of the film, which is another really neat piece to include. And finally, a page out of the Book of Mythology that Dr. Selvig, I think his name was, Dr. Selvig, in the movie, who was the man? Stellan Skarsgård that played him. So if I get the character's name wrong, I know I have the actor right. But it's a page out of that book talking all about the Bifrost, all about Asgard, Odin, Thor, and it looks exactly as it appeared in the movie. And the back has a really nice illustration of Mjolnir. It's just, again, another fantastic folder, great little prop replicas, well worth the money for this set, and we still have one to go. Moving on to the last. Last, but certainly not least, Dr. Bruce Banner. Another file filed by Agent Romanov. You can see Dr. Bruce Banner's name on the tag there on the folder. This one's in nicer shape than Tony Stark's was. She obviously cared a little bit more about this one. The S.H.I.E.L.D. logo yet again. It looks like a manila folder all the way around. Open it up, and we have more goodies. Yay, we love goodies. It has a nice newspaper clipping about the mysterious incident at Culver University's lab. Ooh, which of course was where he was born, at least according to the Incredible Hulk reboot, which I absolutely loved. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. It's great. Love Mark Ruffalo in the role, but Ed Norton did a really fantastic job too. Too bad he couldn't make it for the Avengers, but as I said, Mark Ruffalo did a fantastic job as well. It also comes with a neat little badge for Cryosync, the Stark Industries logo, I suppose, badge for the different cryo chambers that were used to contain the serum, or the wannabe serum for the super soldier serum that Banner was working on. So this is all over the movie. If you're familiar with it, you'll recognize that neat little touch. And it's a metal too. It's actually made out of an actual metallic metal piece, which is just great. It also has a file from Nick Fury detailing Banner and what to do should he become uncontrollable again, that was issued apparently to members of S.H.I.E.L.D. There it goes, it's focused. My camera, ladies and gentlemen. It also has a neat printout in a nice glossy paper off of the Culver University website talking about Dr., or Professor, I should say, Elizabeth Ross, played by Liv Tyler in the movie. Of course, Bruce Banner's fiance, wife, whatever she ended up being, love interest for sure. And all about her, which was again featured in the movie when he was looking up things about her. Another really cool thing that I was not expecting at all, this is a sticker. This is an actual sticker. You can peel off the backing and wrap around any 16-ounce cola bottle to replicate the Pingo Doce Guana drink. This is from the factory that Bruce works in Brazil at the open of the movie. You can actually put this on a bottle of your own and have your own mock beverage from the Incredible Hulk film, which is cool. It even goes all the way down to the nutritional facts about it. Just a neat little detail, really silly but really fun at the same time. Lastly, we have one more blueprint from Stark Industries, believe it or not, which shows the sonic cannon that they ended up using and mounting on Hummers in one of the really great action sequences from the Incredible Hulk. You can sort of make out the Hummer and the big sonic device on the top of it. Again, a great schematic, much like the one that was in Iron Man's featuring the arc reactor. So Hulk's. There's Hulk's folder. Very, very nice. Again, really cool things. A lot I wasn't expecting. Now we'll take a quick look at that confidential envelope from S.H.I.E.L.D., which, of course, was sealed. But if you open it nicely, you can get it open without hurting it too badly. Also, real quick, I do want to point out those files I just brought out do come in a resealable plastic baggie. It actually has a resealable strip on the end, so if you're very careful, you can open and close that over and over and get it shut nicely every time. The S.H.I.E.L.D. folder, of course, when you open it, the envelope has a S.H.I.E.L.D. ID card for you, which has a really great texture to it. It has this cool barcode, the S.H.I.E.L.D. logo, of course, and the back has an exclusive field agent access code that I don't want to give away because I'm sure it unlocks something that I'm aware of or that you can unlock yourself when you get your own collection. So I want to save that. It also has an access to the S.H.I.E.L.D. files card, which is used to gain access to some secret materials that I don't want to spoil here, but you can see it's sort of holographic. It also has words that you line it up basically with something that this comes with, and you can unlock a secret website to access things. It's a neat little touch. Moving on, of course, now we'll take a quick look at the movies themselves. So to do that, of course, we'll need to have the case again. There we go, case. And we'll just open that back up. Ooh, pretty blue lights. Yay, it glows with the power of the Tesseract. And we can just take all our files and slip them right back in, just like that. And of course, again, I said there's a plastic baggie that those can slip into, but I'm not gonna waste time with that. The movies slip right into the sides of the case, just like that. Easily removable, easy to take out, and then of course we can put the case away one more time until it is needed again. And the movies themselves are great. I love the artwork that they decided to go with, and I'm gonna try and do these in order of release if memory serves me correct. So of course, we'll start with Iron Man, which there you see the Mach 1 armor that he builds in the cave with the flamethrowers. If you open it up, it has Tony Stark on the other side, showcasing the Jericho weapon from the beginning of the movie. And I absolutely love the Art Deco retro style that they've gone with, silhouetting the characters, minimal colors, very, very cool. The interior has a brief synopsis of the movie and, of course, the Blu-ray. Next up would be Incredible Hulk. And again, really cool. Great scene from the movie. If you're not familiar with it, that's where he rips a car in half and basically uses each half as boxing gloves to take on the villain in that film, Abomination, who is on the back end of it. And again, just silhouetted. I love how he's in flames. It looks evil. It looks imposing. Interior, again, has a brief synopsis of the film along with the Blu-ray right there. And his is the only one that actually has artwork on the Blu-ray. I thought that was sort of interesting. Next up, of course, we have Iron Man 2, which is really great. Of course, it shows off the two Iron Men in that film, Tony and War Machine, Rhodey. on the backside, it just shows some of the drones that Whiplash builds to take on the two of them. I sort of wish it had Whiplash on there somewhere, but I think that's a bit more interesting, taking on a legion of robotic drones. And the interior, again, has Iron Man 2 Blu-ray right there. Next up, of course, we have, was it Captain America or Thor? Oh my goodness, I'm about to be in trouble here, I think. I believe first we had Thor. So I'm going to do Thor first because I like him. Anyway, I thought that was a fantastic movie. Love the fantasy elements. And you can see we have Thor at the end of the film, of course, with his powers back, taking on the Destroyer. I remembered the Destroyer. And of course, the Destroyer firing its blast at him. And on the back, we have a great picture of Loki on the throne in Asgard. And again, you can see just the silhouettes are great. The colors, I love that minimalist sort of style. It really is cool. And it works very well with these. And this one, of course, features it in Blu-ray and in 3D Blu-ray. And again, a synopsis of the film itself. Next, of course, we have Captain America, the First Avengers. First Avenger, and again, it's Cap from World War II. You notice the classic shield. I love the blues in this one. It's very, very cool. Open it up, and we have Nick Fury on the back, much more modern. You can see the jet that, of course, Steve, Captain America, helped bring down. Nick is holding the Tesseract, and this sort of led us into the Avengers. Inside, again, we have Captain America on Blu-ray and in 3D, and a brief synopsis of the film. Woo! There's a lot here, isn't there, folks? We have next Marvel's The Avengers, which is just awesome. There you go. Every hero on the cover, Hawkeye, Thor, Captain America, Black Widow, Hulk, and Iron Man, all represented. And there's just, you know, you get where they are. It's the city, obviously. Love, just love this artwork. I really, really do. And on the backside, we have Loki, yet again, with the Chitauri Empire behind him. Really great, really nice. Inside, of course, we have it on Blu-ray and in 3D Blu-ray, along with a synopsis of the film. And finally, the bonus disc, The Shield Avengers Initiative, which features a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff. It also features a short film about Item 47, which was made exclusively for this set. You can only get it with this set. I haven't watched that yet, but I'm anxious to. I'm sure it'll be really good. It also contains a brief look at Iron Man 3 and the whole Phase 2 of Marvel's next film endeavor. It's going to be really cool, I think. Lots of neat stuff. Love the silhouette of Nick Fury, obviously on board the helicarrier, and each screen has one of the different heroes. We have Captain America there, Incredible Hulk on that one, Thor, and finally Iron Man. The backside just has the SHIELD logo. Ta-da! And if you look on the inside, we have why SHIELD was founded, basically, the mantra that Nick Fury recites at the beginning of the Avengers cartoon. If you've seen that, you know it. And the disc itself, which has all of the information on there. They called it the Phase 1 Archives. So, altogether, a really, really nice set. I love the DVD, the Blu-ray cases, love that artwork, love how it fits into the larger case. I guess the last thing to look at would be the Tesseract itself, huh? And to look at the Tesseract, of course, we'll need the case back. So here is the case once again. We'll open it up. Ooh, pretty glowing blue light. And we're going to try and put these DVDs back in. I should have paid closer attention to what was where. This will be fine, I'm sure. There we go. Those three go right there. And these right there. And you can see they just slide right on in. No problems, no worries. No getting it caught in the grooves. And the Tesseract simply slides right up out of the center. It's a little sticky to get out of, but I think that's because it's in this plastic wrapper, this clear plastic, that we'll have to take it out of in order to activate and show you. But you can see the light stays on regardless. It's constantly there as long as the case is open. So we'll close up the case, set that aside again, and we have the Tesseract, which, as you can see, they have in some cellophane or something here. So let me get that out real quick, and I'll be right back. So here we have it out of that wrapper, and it is probably the most disappointing thing about the set. There's really nothing to it. As you can see, it's just basically a white frosted cube. You can even sort of see the element inside, the bulb inside that makes it glow and everything. The bottom, of course, has some simple screws where you can put the batteries, replace the batteries, whenever those need to be replaced. It's just not as detailed as I was hoping it would be. It would have been neat to have some sort of something on the outside molded or detailed, some sort of inscriptions or something that you sort of see, or even that sort of wavy element, like power is channeling through it, painted on the outside somehow. I'm not sure how they could have done it, but I'm sure they could have done something. To activate it, you simply smack it. Oh, there it goes. And it'll flash like that for 30 seconds. And if you smack it multiple times, it'll flash faster. Ooh. And that's the Tesseract, basically. There's not a whole lot to it, unfortunately. But all things considered, if this is the worst part, and again, I think it's a great little piece to include, especially when you have it in the case itself. It's a small nitpick that I have, but ultimately I think this thing is outstanding. It is one of the coolest pieces I have in my collection. I'm thrilled to have it. And I mean, just for the case alone, for all the things you have, for the DVDs, Blu-rays, whatever, if you don't have them already and you've been holding out, this is definitely the set to get. It has everything you'll ever want, everything you'll ever need, and a lot of cool sneak peeks at Phase 2 and Iron Man 3, which are coming very, very soon. Iron Man 3 is out in just, what, about a month or so. So that's fantastic. Great set. Well worth the money. Highly recommend it. Get it, get it, get it. If you haven't pre-ordered it, get it now. Find it somewhere. you know, it's worth a couple hundred bucks at least. It really is fantastic. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this look at the Marvel Phase 1 Cinematic Collector's Edition set that I have. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please stay tuned. Please tune in, I should say, for my regular reviews, where I take a look at the DC Comics Superhero Collection by Eagle Moss, little cool statues and things like that, as well as some other things that are comic book, sci-fi, just nerdy in general that I enjoy. If you like this, please check those out. As always, I'm your host, the Monkey Boy, aka J to his friends. Thank you very much for watching.